Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to today's Call of Duty Modern Warfare video. Guys, today I am wearing a Halloween costume. I haven't worn a Halloween costume in a very long time. As a matter of fact, I've never actually bought my own Halloween costume because when my parents stopped buying them for me, I stopped wearing them. But here we are. Let's hop into a game. Alrighty, we found a game. At this point in the game... Oh, real quick, before I forget. Guys, comment down below if you know who I am. But guys, at this point, this is the class I'm using in Call of Duty now. The explosive shotgun and the Cali sticks. I'm not even running Ghost anymore. I'm running Hardline because you don't need Ghost with this class. Because I literally one-shot UAVs and two-shot personal radars. Now, this is absolutely my first game on. So, if I do terribly, that's my excuse. Just so you guys know, I am pre-gaming the excuses. That's how I rolled. That guy just quick shot me, and I'm so happy phase 5 is finally done, or at least like moving on to the next step. So there's only 100 people left instead of like 100,000 people. That guy got me again. He better be one of the phase 5 like move-ons. Otherwise, why are you still sniping? As a matter of fact, I'm gonna say it. Why are people sniping for phase 5 when FaZe isn't even a sniping team anymore? FaZe is a Fortnite team now, but that's besides the point. Guys, yesterday I drove for 7 hours. I was gone all day. I have zero kills and a lot of deaths right now. Is that a... Okay. Yeah, we finally officially closed on our land. Like, the land, that process, like, all that stuff I've been talking to you guys about us buying our land, it's done. It's our land now. I don't think I have a single kill yet at this point, and I don't even care, dude, because we're in a Halloween costume, and we're gonna vibe. There we go, we got one. It's pretty awesome, though. We finally have the land. Starting in November, we're gonna be paying our first, like, payments on it, and it's awesome. Like, it's our land now. We went, I posted a picture of it yesterday on Twitter, like, last night when I got home, because I didn't have, you know, I wasn't home, so I couldn't have, like, linked my video at 6 or whatever, like I normally do on Twitter. So I linked my video and I posted a picture of Taylor and I. That's my wife, if you don't know. Taylor and I at... Wait, did I just get aim assist on someone? I did. I wasn't paying attention. I'm so stupid. But us on our land, right now it is a cornfield. Thankfully, the cornfield is actually knocked down now. So now it's just ground. We have a lot of work to do. We know that. But we know exactly what we need to do and how to do it. And at this point... It's just a waiting game until we have to wait until the ground gets like frozen for us to do our next step that we need to do. I'm actually surprised that I don't run into more of these shotguns. Oh, I'm glad this guy threw a trophy system. This does not even get countered by the trophy system, by the way. I've shot it directly at a trophy. It just breaks the trophies. It doesn't. The trophy does not counter. And even if it did counter it, I have 8 shots on the clip. And a trophy only blocks like what? 2, I think. Maybe 3. I'm not even 100. I think it's only 2. Only blocks 2 things. So I still have like 6 more shots even if it did block it. So as a matter of fact, actually, I kind of wish that this thing did block or did get blocked by trophies because then I can destroy trophies quicker. That guy who just killed me is the guy who was sniping me earlier. He's a phase 5, like, overkill nerd. Wonder how long it takes for me to shoot down a... Oh, you know what? I think my teammate was helping shoot that down. Oddly enough, I almost have the most amount of kills on my team right now. I have 7 kills. The 2 people with the most have 9, even though I started this game off like 0-5 or something like that, or 0-6, like something crazy. Where is this guy? Where do I hear these shots from? I don't know. Oh, here we are. God, that wasn't the guy, but where's the other guy that's around here? But yeah, I almost have this shotgun gold. Literally haven't even attempted to do a single challenge. I was just looking today. I was trying to put on a camo on this, and I realized I almost have a gold. The only thing I really don't have is like the 3 kills without dying because I kill myself a lot with it, or we've been playing a lot of search. And then I have almost 0 kills where you have to get like kills with no attachments because I've been running attachments. Because I picked up, like, I was using this gun before I even unlocked it. I just picked it up off the ground. So I had attachments right away. But yeah, so we were gone all day yesterday. 13-hour day. We drove 3.5 hours on our way there. We closed on our land. I have the title for the land now, so it is officially in our name. We have to pay the taxes on it. Hashtag thank you government for taxes. LOLOL. That was a meme, by the way. I'm not thanking the government for taxes, but it is in our name. We're officially paying the taxes on it now. And then is this guy still alive back here? There's no way, right? I have Cali sticks. I'll come back here and spank you, nerd. Come here. Where are you at? Where are you? He must be dead. Oh, this is him. He did die. All right, here we go. I've been running around the map. Finally got a kill, dude. I had to run my way back. But yeah, so we're paying the taxes on that. So that's officially ours. Starting November, we pay the first payment. But we did sign everything. So it's ours now. Pretty excited. We went over like to our land yesterday. Wait, is this guy going to drop on me? He is. We went over to our land yesterday, checked it out. That's obviously how I got that picture of Taylor and I at our land, which was really cool. And then we went to the place where we're buying our house from. Now, once again, if you guys don't know, the house we bought... is like, it's a nice house, but it's still a temporary house. So what our game plan is we're going to live in that house for, I mean, it depends. 5 to 10 years is kind of like what we're guesstimating. But truly, I mean, it could be 1 year. It could be, I don't know, 15 to 20 years. It all depends on, you know, how life goes and like money and all that stuff. But our plan is to live in that house for a period of time. And then we're going to actually build like a dream home on that same piece of property, because we have 4.5 acres. We're going to build an actual dream home on that same piece of property. Keep the temporary house there. It's a modular home. Keep that there. And then what we'll do is we'll either keep that modular home there for guests to literally have an entire house to have, because I'm not going to rent it to strangers. I'm not renting. I don't want to be a landlord. I'm not. That's too much stress. Or we're going to, the real plan is to have my mother-in-law just live in it, because right now she, like where we're moving to and where she lives pretty far away. And we just have a feeling that she's going to want to live near us. And so basically, unless she moves sooner, obviously, if she moves sooner, then she'd have to get her own house, because we know we won't be able to move out yet. But if she were to wait, then we could, I mean, we'll just basically just give her a house for free, which works out for her. I mean, that's a free retirement plan, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, we went to the place for a modular home. We picked all the colors and everything. And by we, I mean Taylor picked all the colors. And she, I'm going to be honest with you guys, there was an option for a master bedroom. And the door from the master bedroom to the master bathroom, there was an option for a barn door that was $800 that Taylor said yes to. Now, she said yes so fast, I didn't even have a second to even think about what just happened. The lady there, like, looked at me for approval, like, is this okay for her to pick the $800 door? And I just shook my head yes out of, like, I shook my head yes, because I was just like, so in awe, like, how fast she said yes. She was like, do you want the barn door? She's like, yes, yes, yes. And the lady was like, it's $800. And she's like, yes, yes, yes. And I was like, okay, yes, 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 I guess. So yeah, we have an $800 door. So that's the life I'm living right now, but it's okay. I just realized how bad we're losing this game. Let's hop on this. Let's hop on this hill. Let's start playing a better team. I can imagine I'm going super negative, but that's okay. Because if you guys didn't watch my other video on Thursday, we like going negative now, because then it helps us get easier games for skill-based matchmaking. That's how we love it, because we love having our skill-based matchmaking nice and low, so then our like streams are a lot easier, a lot more enjoyable. It's a lot easier when your skill-based matchmaking is low and you stream, because then you can just beast up on nerds who like don't even know what they're doing. What is happening? Why am I spawning in between enemies? And if you didn't watch my video from Thursday, oh no, I forgot to mute my phone. If you didn't watch my video from Thursday, you should go watch it. It's actually one of my, it's like kind of like a funny skit video, but like, you know what I'm saying? It's just, you should definitely watch it. It's called, modded RPG skill-based matchmaking fix or something along the lines of that, but we are getting smoked right now. I gotta get my head in the game. I've just slurped down some G Fuel using code EMGG. Let's get our head in the game. Also use code EMGG at checkout for Scuff Gaming, DX Tracer, and Meta Threads as well. And I'm pretty sure I really should have checked, but I know that the EMGG code for G Fuel was just 30% off. I'm pretty sure it still is. So check it. I mean, if it's not 30% off, it is definitely at least 10, but I'm pretty sure it's 30% off still. I should have checked before I started talking to you guys. I got quickscoped again by the guy using overkill. What a punk. You know, at this point, these guys can win. The amount of deaths I just cut out, the amount of times I have been stunned, and then they slide cancel around the corner with like their overkill guns and have killed me. These guys can honestly have the win. I don't even want to win. Matter of fact, I'm okay with losing. Once again, I want the skill-based matchmaking to go like away. So I'm like totally down to lose. Let's see how long it takes for me to kill this thing without any help from anyone else. 3? Okay. Takes 3. Let me beat your face in, you nerd. Give me this MP5. Give me the MP5. Oh, you hear it? Dang it, dude. They're always here. Okay, I'm okay with losing, to be honest. I mean, these guys, they wanted it way more than I did. I must have done good in my previous game to have these guys trying so hard because skill-based matchmaking is in the game. Which, by the way, semi-trolling with, but obviously skill-based matchmaking is in Call of Duty, but it's just fun to troll about it now. Oh, here's the overkill guy. Hey, good on you, overkill guy. Hope you have a fantastic day. 26 and 36, let's go, dude! Next game's gonna be so much easier. Thank you guys for stopping by today's video. If you're still here, please leave a like on the video, guys. It would greatly help me out if you guys like the video, because it helps my video get recommended to more people, which gets us more subscribers. We're almost to 600, dude. I can't believe that. I can't believe, dude, at the beginning of this year, we were at 100. We're almost at 600 right now. That is insanity. Don't forget to comment down below if you know what my costume is. and I'll see you guys all later. Goodbye.